degree 1, 2, 3 are called linear, quadratic polynomials. You know that degree 1 polynomials of degree 1 are called linear, 2 are called quadratic, and degree 3 are called cubic polynomials. And if you go for the geometric meaning of polynomial, of a polynomial, the zeros of the polynomial, say p of x, are precisely the x coordinates where the graph of y equal to p of x intersects x. A quadratic polynomial p of x equal to x plus c can have at most two zeros because its degree, and a cubic polynomial can have three zeros because its degree is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is the general polynomial. Of course, children, cubic polynomial is not there in the syllabus. There is no. If alpha a and b, actually it should be alpha and beta. Beta are the zeros of ax square plus bx plus c. Then sum of zeros is given by minus b by a. Product of zeros is given by c. Okay, these are the things we already know. Now, certain questions. The graph of a polynomial is given. Find the number of zeros. It is the graph. It is intersecting. X-axis intersects the x-axis. Of course, definitely intersects three places. You can see here, here, and here. Therefore, what? How many zeros it has?
It has 3 zeros, sir.
There are 3 zeros of the polynomial. These are all simple, which may be asked in under MCQs. So get answer this. And next, here the graph of p of x is given in the figure below. For some polynomials p of x, number of zeros of p of x here. For the first one, how many zeros will be there?
No.
Zero, sir.
Zero, sir.
Zero.
Yeah, very good.
No zero.
The graph is not correct. The graph is not intersecting the axis. Therefore, it has no zeros. Zero zeros will be there. The graph is intersecting at one place, therefore only one zero. Yes.
Three, sir.
Right. How many zeros are there? Tell me. In the sixth question, please. Unmute the mic.
Three, sir.
Here also three, because the graph is the x-axis at three places, so it is three. Now in case five, we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 zeros. And in this case, there are two zeros. And such a graph is called a parabola, children. Parabola. What is this called? And graph of a quadratic polynomial. Graph of a quadratic polynomial is a parabola, we say. And the parabola can be in different forms. We discussed this earlier classes. So that is not required now. Now let us move on to another question, which is very commonly asked in the exams. Find the zeros of the quadratic polynomials and verify the relationship between the zeros and their for p of x equal to x square minus 2x minus 8. This is the question. Firstly, we find out what are the polynomial first. What are the zeros we will find out first? To find the zeros, we use splitting the middle term. We split the middle term as, see, it is 2x. So minus 4, minus 2,
minus,
split into minus 4x plus 2x. It is. Again, the product is minus 8. The sum is minus 2. Right. Therefore, to write again the common factors. X is taken common from the first. So x into x minus 4 plus 2 is taken common here, 2 plus 4. Then we have x minus 4 into x plus 2 as the factors of this particular polynomial. We factorize splitting between term process. Next, x minus 4 is equated to 0. One of the factors is equated to 0. Then we get the value of x. And the second factor, when you equate to 0, you get the value of x as minus. And now, we know the zeros. We know the coefficients. Coefficients are here. We understand what are the coefficients of this particular equation here. For example, that is x square coefficient a equal to 1, x coefficient b equal to minus 2, and the constant term is minus 8. A equal to 1, b equal to minus 2, c equal to. Let us understand what is the sum of zeros, plus 4, plus 2, and minus b by a. What is minus of, find here, that is minus of minus 2. By 1, of course, there is no difference. It is not changing the value here, it is plus 2. So, sum equal to minus b by a is 4 here. Then product of zeros is 4 into minus 2, that is minus 8. Now c by a I will check here. This is by 1, it is minus 8. So product of zeros is equal to, so it is proved that, or it is verified that sum of zeros is 2. Minus b by a, product of zeros equal to c. Sum of zeros is often denoted with the symbol alpha and product of zeros alpha beta. Remember this one. Now, find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship again. One, I think you have, you know these questions, so I am not giving you time to note down. So, keep things, once again, you practice them. Right? Write the equation so that you can do the process at home again. P of x equal to x square plus 7x plus 2. Once again, we split the middle term 7x plus 4x because 3 into 4 is 12. Now, it can be written as x plus 3 into x plus 4. Now, equal to 0, where, therefore, when it is equated, we get the zeros of the polynomial as x equal to minus 3 and x equal. So we take the, we know the zeros now. Sum of zeros is minus 7, and the is equal to coefficient of x, that is minus b, minus 7 by b is 1. So it is proved here, verified here. Next, product of zeros is equal to minus 3 into minus 12. R 12 is nothing but 12 by 1, nothing but by coefficient of x square. Constant term, term by coefficient of x square. Either way, we can write, either you can write it as minus b by c by a, or constant term by coefficient of x square, coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, like this. I think you can have a click quickly. Okay, shall we move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Here we have x square minus 2x. For this, we are again factorizing. We know how to the factorization process, so I am not it so detailedly. Now, the value of this one is 0 when x equal to x plus x. 0 or x plus 2 equal to 0. That means the zeros of this polynomial are 4 and therefore, again, sum of zeros is taken. Minus of coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, that is minus 2 by 1. Actually, one line is missing here. Don't worry. Line I am drawing now. Line is missing because it is difficult to present all this in PowerPoint presentation. Right. So, product of zeros. Sum of zeros, verification of the relation between the zeros and the coefficients of the polynomial. Important, it's an important model. Okay, this model we learn now. Now we move on to the next type question, right? Here also the same question, of course. X square minus 3 minus 7x. It is from the text. Firstly, we have to keep the equation in the. See, here x term is given, here coefficient is given. Therefore, I is to like this minus 7x minus 3. These two, they have changed the places now. We put them in the right places. And when you factorize it, it comes 3x plus 1 into 3x minus 3. So factorization is also simple, children. 3, 6 are 18. And that too, it is minus 18. Minus is written as, minus 9 into 2 actually. Minus 2 plus 2. Minus 9 plus 2, of course, when you add these two, you will get minus 7x. Then this is written as 6x square. Very, very, very difficult to write with mouse. Minus 9x. 9x. Minus 2x, sorry, plus 2x. This is x, of course, x, and here it is minus 3. Then from the first two terms, if you take 3x common, what will happen? This will be here 2x is and minus 3 is left out here. 2x minus 3, and here already 2x minus 3 is there, so plus 1 I will take common here, because 1 is the common factor for minus 3, no common factors, so I will take plus side and 2x minus 3. Now minus 3 is a common factor for both, so it is taken here, and 3x plus, this is the factorization for 6x square minus 3. And therefore, when the first factor is equated to 0, it is 3. And the second factor is equated to 0, it is 3 by 2. So again, sum of zeros is equal to minus 1 by 3 plus 3 by 2. Again, you have to take LCM here, 6. And 2, minus 2 and plus 9, it is minus 7. So it is less of minus 7 are simply coefficient of x by coefficient of x. Constant term by coefficient of x square will come for product of zeros. So then all these questions you have to practice again and again. All these regular classes were going on during this year. Okay, in the month of July, first week we did this. Now find the quadratic polynomial. This is another important model, and it also whose zeros are 3 plus root 5 and 3 minus root 5. Then the required polynomial is x minus of one of the values, let it be alpha and beta. When zeros are known, then the required x minus alpha multiplied by x plus x minus beta. Okay, this is the polynomial. So here I am writing x minus 3 plus root 5, x minus 3 minus. Further, I open the brackets, then 3 minus root 5 multiplied by x minus 3 minus plus root 5. Plus root 5. Then x minus 3 into minus root 5, x minus 3 is root 5. Then it will be x minus 3 and minus 5 root 5, it is like a minus b into a plus b, a square minus b square, x minus 3 whole square minus root 5 square. It is x square 2 into x into 3 plus 3 square minus minus 5. That means x square plus 6 minus 9 minus 5 are x square minus 6x plus 4. Find the quadratic polynomial whose zeros are given. Next, one more of this kind. You can quickly look into this one. Now zeros are 5 plus root 2 minus root 2. Then, if alpha beta are the. Now you can directly write another formula also. You can use this particular method to find the quadratic polynomial. X minus alpha x plus alpha beta. Children, in fact, there should be a k also, because there can be any number of polynomials with the same zeros. Alright. So here alpha is 5 plus and beta is 5 minus root 2. So alpha plus beta I am taking as root 2 plus 5 minus root 2. Root 2 and root 2 are cancelled here. Where is my cursor? Here. Root 2 plus root 2 and minus root 2 are cancelled. Therefore, 5 plus 5, 10. 10 is the sum of the zeros. When you multiply alpha and beta, 5 plus root 2 is root 2. It is like a plus b into a minus b square. A square meaning 5 square, that is 25. Minus root 2 square, it is 2. It is 23 now. So alpha beta value, alpha plus beta is 10. Now let us put these values in this formula or the other equation. So p of x equal to x square minus alpha plus beta is 10. So 10 into x plus alpha beta is 16, 23. That is the quadratic polynomial required. So make a note of this. Such questions are quite common in the final exam. So be ready to answer such questions. Right? Now we'll move on to the next one. Right. Important one again. Here we know what is the value of term. The polynomial is given. We have to find the values of alpha plus alpha beta square and 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. Here we have sum of zeros and the product of zeros first. Here in the polynomial, a equal to 2, a equal to 2, b equal to, the pen color change. Okay, a equal to 2, b equal to minus, c equal to 7 now. C equal to 7. So, a 2, b minus 5, c. Alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. We learned that, we have verified that fact. Sum of zeros is equal to x coefficient, minus of x coefficient by x square coefficient. Is minus of minus 5 by 2, it is 5 by 2. Now we know what is the value of beta. Alpha beta is equal to c by a or by 2 here. Now let me take alpha square plus, you have to remember the algebra children here. Alpha square plus beta square, it is 9 b square. A square plus b square equal to a plus b whole square minus 2ab. Alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. So alpha plus beta is not. Everything is known. So alpha plus beta is known, 5 by 2. 5 by 2 whole square minus 2 into 7 by 2. These two will be kept. And 25 by 4 minus 7 is taken as LCM. 25 minus 28. 28 here. When you take LCM, 5 minus 28 is minus 3. So minus 3 by 4 is the answer here. That is alpha beta square value. 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta is still easy. When you take LCM for these two, alpha beta is LCM. So alpha or alpha plus beta. 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta is nothing but beta by alpha beta. Now, alpha plus beta means that is 5 by 2. So, 5 by 2 divided by 7 by 2. So, when there is a division of, it's a division of fractions, we change like this. With division, we change into multiplication. First, we keep as it is. We will multiply the first fraction by the reciprocal of the second fraction by 7. And 2 are cancelled, 5 by 7 is the value here. Question and easy question also. You should not lose marks for this, for such questions. So, understand children. This may be asked under quadratic equations also. Both are same. But the quadratic polynomial, only the difference is quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. So a polynomial when equated to 0, it becomes a quadratic equation. Remember, remaining things we'll see later. Now the next, only I'm discussing the questions because you know about the textbook questions. So certain important questions I am discussing in the revision. Find a quadratic polynomial. The sum of 4 zeros is 0 and 1 0 is 5. Right. What are those? Let us see. Here the zeros be a and b. So a plus b equal to 0 now, because sum of 1 is 0. And then one of the zeros is 5 here. Zeros is 5. So what you do? You write in. Write 5. So 5 plus 0, 5 plus b, or b equal to minus 5 now. B equal to minus 5. Is 5, another 0 is minus 5. Therefore, sum of product of 0, 5 into minus 5, is, that is minus 25. 5 5 is minus 25. And sum of zeros, you know, 0. Therefore, we take the sum is 0, product is minus 5. So, is given as x square minus sum of plus product of zeros. So here x square minus 25, or rather it is x square minus 25. But a simple, what an important one. So all of you make a note of learning this process. Next, we have another question. Sum and product of the zeros are given. What is the quadratic polynomial? Almost same is the process here. Sum of zeros, product of zeros. As I told you, you have to write the equation like k minus sum of the zeros plus into x plus product of zeros. If you don't write k, it's not wrong, but there will be polynomials with these zeros. With 1 by 2 and minus 3 are zeros, there can be infinite number of polynomials. Therefore, we say this is one of the polynomials. When you multiply it by k, you get one more polynomial. This way we say. So, x square minus 1 by 2 into x. Okay. Why it is so? Because x square, sum of zeros is minus, so minus 1 by 2 into x, product of zeros is minus 3. We are writing minus 3. So, I will take the value of plus 2, because this 1 by 2, in 1 by 2, 2 is the denominator. The denominator can be, I mean, the fraction can be avoided here. 10 by 2. So 2 into x square, 2x square, 1 by 2 into x, that is 1 by 2 into 2, x minus 6. So that means here also I have to write k. If I go to write, you can write, of course, like this. This is put in brackets and be written here. And k is to be written here. I think it is clear. Now, another question on this.
Sir, can you show me?
What the previous screen?
Yes, sir.
Is that okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
There are number of questions. On polynomials lesson children, and from this lesson the division of polynomials and the division algorithm for polynomials is completely delicious for this year. Therefore, you need not study. Exercise is not required. Third exercise from the chapter is not required. Fourth exercise, I think it is. Fourth exercise. No, third exercise. Third exercise related, you need not study that. Okay? Next. For B, is polynomial. Polynomial, this one divisible by x minus 3. Division is deleted, but divisibility can be done using theorem and remainder theorem, what you learned in 9th class. So let us theorems now. So let the polynomial be f of x, actually x cube, children, not x square, it is x cube. X cube minus 3x square plus bx minus 6. So if it is divisible by x minus 3, 0. So what is the remainder? Remainder is nothing but f of, that is f of 3 here, f of 3. So f of 3, so if it is divisible by x minus 3. We discussed this in 9th class itself. So x minus f of 3 I am finding now. In place of x, I will write 3. 3 cube minus 3 into 3 square plus b into 3 minus 6 equal to 0. So meaning 27 minus 27 plus 3 square is 9, place of 27. These two are cancelled. 6 equal to 0, or 3b is equal to 6, or b. So value of b is found here using the remainder theorem. Factor theorem, remainder theorem we found now. Shall we move on to the next one?
Sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very simple question. Learn a basic question in this. It may be a one mark or object type question. Find the sum and product of zeros of this one. Very simple. Sum minus 2 you have to write, children, because sum is minus 2 and that is minus of 2 by 1. Okay? And product is minus 15, C by A, that is minus 15 by 1. This you have to, that's why they give like this. Okay? Then one more question. If the sum of zeros of a quadratic polynomial, sum of zeros of a quadratic polynomial is 40. Quadratic polynomial is f of x equal to x square minus 8kx plus 10 equal to 40. What is the value of k? Find the value of k. Okay, I think it should be a small. There is a doubt. F, find the value of k equal to 5. Of course, I gave the answer here right straight away. It's because you have to value sum of zeros, you know, minus b by a. Minus. So, what is minus b? Minus of minus 8k. Minus 8k. Minus of minus 8k by 1 by C by A, B by A, minus of minus B by A, minus of minus 8K by 1 is equal to 40. Or simply you can say 40K equal to 5 then. Is it not? So that is the way. The product of zeros of, here a quadratic polynomial is given, children. Now let me erase. So you can clearly understand what is this. Okay. Is if the product, find the value of k. Product of zeros is given by c by a. You all know what is the value of c here? It is k. K by 1 is minus 2. The equation you have to write. K by 1 is equal to K by 1 is equal to minus 2. Or what is the value of K then? K equal to minus 2. K equal to minus 2. That's the answer. Understand? You can do problems on